Hello children, today we are going to study lesson 8 of your English 2, that is the song of the train. Okay, the song of the train. Now why this title, children? The song of the train, it is because we will see the in this story we will see the train journey through the eyes of a small girl. Okay, and her name is Minnie. Okay, and Minnie has never been on a train before, and so everything is new to her. Okay, and the sound that the train makes while moving, that is like music to her. That is why the name Song of the Train. Okay, and it is so soothing, and also that it helps her to keep company to her throughout the journey. Okay, and she likes the how the this quick sudden, you know, short movement, and it feels like the train is singing for her. So that is why the name given is Song of the Train. Okay, so I will read it para wise, and I will explain. Minnie and her mother and her father are going to visit Minnie's grandparents. They are traveling by train. Minnie is 6 years old, but she never traveled on a train before. So everything is new to her. So children, as I told you, that is a small girl whose name is Minnie, and she is traveling on a train for the first time. So she is sharing her experience, her first time experience on train, and she is traveling with whom? With her parents. Traveling means what? Traveling means when you go from one place to another place, that is traveling. It can be by train, it can be by road, you know, when you go in a car or something, then it can be by aeroplane or something. So when you move from one place to another, that is known as traveling. Okay, so this Minnie was traveling with her father and mother for the first time on a train, and she's small. How old she is? She's just 6 years old. Okay, but she has never traveled on a train before, so everything is new to her. So because she's just 6 years old and she has never traveled before, so this is her first journey on a train, and everything is new to her. Okay, the train whistled twice, hoot hoot. So when the train is about to move, it whistles, right? So the train whistled twice. Why did the train whistle twice? It is about to leave the platform. Okay, that is why it is giving signal to the passengers that everyone, those who are on means not have not moved in, on a train till now, they should get inside because train is about to leave the platform. There was a slight jerk and the train started. First, it moved slowly. Chuk, chuk, chuk. Okay. Slight jerk. Slight means short, very small. And jerk means this short movement. Chhatka lagna in Hindi, as we say. So, there is a sudden, quick, short movement. And with that movement, the train actually starts. Okay. So, how did the train move? First, it moved slowly. And then it moves faster. See here, soon it went faster and faster. Chuk, 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 chuk. Like this the train makes sound, no? So, for how did this train move? First, it moved slowly and then it moved faster, okay? Minnie looked out of the window. It was a sunny afternoon. A man was working in the fields. A woman was drawing water from a well. Some children were playing. They looked at the train and waved. Even the trees waved their branches. So, as I told you, that it was the first journey of Minnie. So, she was very excited. And she wanted to, enjoy everything. She wanted to, and she means did not want to miss anything. So she was looking outside, and she was trying to see everything that she could see from the train. So and who was traveling with her. Her parents were traveling with her, so she was very, you know, carefree that her parents were there, so she was not scared also to go on a train. And Minnie looked out of the window. It was a sunny afternoon. So what time they start the journey? In the afternoon. Okay, so they started the journey in the afternoon and it was a bright sunny day. And when she was looking outside, what did she find? She saw a man in the fields. Okay, a man was working, maybe a farmer or something. He was working in the fields. And then what did she see? What else? A woman was drawing water from a well. Drawing water means what? Means pulling bucket full of water from the well. Okay, so village woman was there who was drawing water from the well. They some children were playing also. She saw that some village children were there and they were playing in the field or on the road. They looked, and you know, when the village children are playing and the train passes, they also get very excited, small children, and they start waving at the train. They looked at the train and waved. You remember the story Kaku and the Lal Hawa, how Kaku used to wave at the train. The name was given Lal Hawa. Similarly, like this also, small children of the village, they were they enjoy waving, saying bye to train. Even the trees waved their branches, and it was looking like a wind was there, and it was looking like the branches of the trees were also shaking, and it appeared like they are also waving at the moving train. The trees are running so fast, said Minnie. See, Minnie's small, she's just 6 years old, okay, and she's innocent. And when she is sitting in the train and the train is moving fast, so to her it looks like that the trees are moving, but actually what is happening? The trees are not moving, the trees are there itself, and the train is moving. And because the train is moving, so it looks like that the trees are also moving. So it appears to her like that trees are also moving very fast. No, Minnie, laughed her mother. The trees are not running. So when she said to her mother that, mother, see, the trees are moving so fast, the mother laughed. She said, Minnie, trees are not moving. Actually, the train is moving and it's looking like the trees are moving with us. Turn your page, children. Page number 68. The train is moving and we are moving with it. So, mother explained that the train is moving, and so it is looking like the trees are moving with us. Your tickets, please, said a man in uniform. Okay. Who is this man? Whispered Minnie. So who came then after this? A man came and who was wearing a black suit, turban, tie, you can see in the picture, no? So who is this man? He is a ticket checker, okay? He is a TC, one who checks the ticket. So this TC comes in the train to check whether the passengers are carrying right tickets or not, okay? So the ticket checker came and he asked for the tickets. Who is this man? Whispered Minnie. Whispered means to speak very slowly, okay, that the other person cannot hear. So Minnie saw first time that who is this person who is coming here and asking for tickets from us. She asked her mother, she inquired, she got curious about this. He is the ticket examiner. Examiner means one who examines, one who checks, okay, replied Minnie's father. He wants to see our tickets. So Minnie's father told Minnie that he's a ticket checker and he has come to check our tickets. Minnie's mother gave their tickets to the man. He looked at them, and then Minnie's mother took out the tickets from her purse and she gave the tickets to the ticket checker. Thank you, he said, and gave the tickets back to her. So the ticket checker, what did he do? He took the tickets, he matched it with the list he was carrying. The name, their names were there in the list, and then you return the tickets to back to them saying thank you. Minnie looked out of the window. It was beautiful outside. So once again Minnie wanted to she didn't want to miss any sight. Sight means view, scenery. It is very, the sceneries are very nice. Now when you go on a train and when you look outside, it, the scenes we don't get to see in the cities and all, because in the cities so many buildings and concrete things are there. So when we go on a train and we pass by villages and all, there is so much greenery, there are rivers, there are when you go towards hilly side, there are mountains. So the sight, the view, is the scenery is very beautiful. So Minnie was enjoying, she was seeing all these things for the first time from a train. So she didn't want to miss any sight. So again she started looking out of the window. The sun was setting. It looked like a giant orange. So now see, they started when it was afternoon, okay, and now the time has passed and now it is the sun was setting, so it was almost evening time. And when the sun sets, when the sun goes down, the sky becomes orangish, the sun also becomes orange, okay. So means it was looking, to Minnie it was looking like it was a giant means very big. So it was looking like a big orange because it was round and orange in color, so it was looking like a big orange. So imaginative this little Minnie is, right. Herds of cattle were walking across the fields. Herds means children, group of animals. This you have studied. Cattle means the farm animals, the animals that live on farm, like cows, goats, buffaloes. These are all farm animals. They are cattle. So herds of cattle were walking across the fields. Flocks of birds were flying in the sky. When the sun sets, the birds, they go back to their home, right? So flock means group of birds. So all birds were going back to their a nest, to their shelter, you can say. And these animals like cows, buffaloes, goats, they are also going back to their homes. Then the sun went behind a hill. Soon it began to grow dark. And then the sun actually means it's the sun get the sun got down behind behind at the back of a hill mountain. And when the sun went down, it got means dark. It was night time now. Lights came on in the train, and when it is dark, the lights which were in the train, they were automatically switched on. Okay. Dinner coupons, said a man, and after that a man came and he said, if you want to take dinner coupons. Coupons means children, they are special tickets to buy food and all. Okay, so on a train there are no shops. Now you cannot, there are no kitchens that you can go and make food for yourself. So you are dependent on the train staff for the food and all. So man came and he said that if you want to take dinner, you can buy coupons. Minnie's mother bought 3 coupons. So there were 3 people, Minnie's father and mother. So she bought 3 coupons for themselves. The train was slowing down. Chuk, chuk, chuk. Now, when the station comes, any platform comes, the train slows down the speed. So now the train was slowing down. It means what? That some station, some important station was coming. Then the train stopped. Bright light came in through the window. So after that, when the train slowed down and finally it stopped, and then the bright lights were coming through the window. Till now it was not, the light was were not coming from the window because it was dark outside. But as the train reached the station on the platform, there were shops outside. Platform means children what? Means the part of at the site of the railway track, okay, the place in the railway station which is at the side of the or next to the railway tracks, okay, where you know people get off the train and few people get on the train. So that is platform. So it is an important station, said Minnie's father. the train will stop here for some time. Now there was, it was a big station, and on big stations train stops for some time, right? So that people who want to get off the train, they can get off, and the people who wants to get on the train, they can come inside the train. So Mini's father said that it is an important station, big station, and here train will halt for some time. The platform was full of people. The platform where means the train was means standing, there were a lot of people on that platform. Porters were carrying boxes on their heads. Porters means children, the person who carries luggage of the passengers, the suitcases, or you can say coolies that are present on the station. So they were carrying boxes on their heads and shoulders. Some people were selling things, and vendors are also there on the platform, and they sell things, eatables, or sometimes they sell books and all. Everything means importantly, you can get it on the big platforms. Everyone is in a hurry, Mini thought. So Mini thought that means everyone was rushing somewhere, moving out of the train. Some were in a hurry to get inside the train. Everyone was moving here and there, because in a platform there is a hurry, now so that we can miss the train. So everyone moves fast. So she was watching that here everyone is in a hurry. Now turn your page. Page number 70. The train started again and left the station behind. Then the food came in 3 packets. Okay, so here after some time, when the time was up, that it was time for this much time only, the train was supposed to stop at the station, and when the time was over, the train started moving again. Okay, and after that it left that station, and then means the food which they have ordered, it also came. 3 packets of food was delivered to them. After she ate, Minnie asked, "Now where do I sleep?" Now Minnie has eaten food and all. Now she was thinking that, because when you don't sleep, there are only 2 berths, and berth means what? The place where you sleep on the train, that is berth. There are 3 berths: lower berth, middle berth, and upper berth. Okay, one side, and same 3 berths on the opposite side. So 6 berths, and 2 are also on the opposite side. So in one compartment there are actually total 8 berths. Okay, so because this was the first journey Mini was experiencing, so she was thinking that where will I sleep? "We have 3 berths," explained Mini's father. "An upper berth, a middle berth, and a lower berth." Now Minnie's father wanted to satisfy her query. Her means she was anxious to know. So he told that we have reserved 3 berths for ourselves, and that means the lower one, middle, and the upper one. Minnie's father lifted Minnie and put her in the middle berth. He then covered her with a blanket. Soon he switched off the lights and turned on the night light. You can see in the picture also, children, that how Minnie's father has arranged, means lifted the middle berth and kept all the pillow and all, and he lifted Minnie, and he made her lie on the middle berth, and she was covered with blanket and all, everything. And then her father switched off the light and turned on the night light. And night light means it is not very bright, it's very dim light, so that everything is visible. The train sped through the night. Choo 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 choo. So the train sped through the night. Sped means, children, to move with a great speed. Now it was a night time and the train was moving at a great speed. Minnie listened. Choo choo choo. She thought, "It's the song of the train. It's singing for me." Now Minnie was listening to the this song that was this train was making, and she found that sound very soothing to her ears. She actually liked the sound that was produced, and she was thinking that the train is singing for her, and she was enjoying the song. And soon she was fast asleep, and listening to the song of the train, she soon fell asleep, and she was means fast asleep. Means fast asleep means in a deep sleep, because she was small, so the song made her sleep soundly. Okay, so children, this was the story, the song of the train. Hope you have liked the story. So read the story once and learn all the word meanings that are given in this chapter. Thank you.